Joe, this is your album launch for Classic, album number two. How does it feel?
It's very exciting. I feel a lot more relaxed this time round. I feel a bit more like I know what's going on. I was a bit like a rabbit in the headlights. You know, because I've experienced a lot since the first album. And I know what I'm... I feel like I know what I'm doing a bit more now. And I think, you know, after Pop Star, Opera Star, I was like... We had the option to kind of spend a lot of time. And I was like, you know, I spent a lot of time with the first album. Let's just go for it. Let's get the team on board. Let's go for it and really just bash it out. And I made sure that because we'd done it so fast, that the quality was still there, which was important. But, yeah, we really worked hard to get it turned around fast.
Fast isn't the word. This has to be the fastest ever.
6 days. I'm pretty exhausted. It was really exciting for me to do it in 6 days. It was kind of, I had so many creative ideas flowing and ideas that it was kind of nice because it was just all like rolling off each other. I was like, and we'll do this and we'll do that and we'll do this. You know what I mean?
And switch off. I mean, you win Opera Star. Was there a part of you that thought, now, should I take this gamble? Should I go down this route or you have to just go with it?
I don't think it was a gamble because I heard on the street I was doing shows inside the show on different days through the week and things like that. And the reaction I was getting from the opera, people were begging for it. Like, please sing this and Doma, please sing this, please. And I thought, you know, we'd been having these discussions previous to the show about a new deal and things like that. And it wasn't until, like, I realised how much people wanted it, including the album, I was like, you know, I've got to give people what they want. And we sat down with the label after I won. I was like, we need to include this in and make some kind of concept where we include it all in that everybody wants to hear. And hence why we included Dance of My Father. I promised I would record that song. And we did it with a bit of different spin with an orchestra and things. And I'm just so glad that I've been able to incorporate it all into one genre.
Developed so much vocally, we obviously saw you go on that journey.
I'm really proud of the album, you know, and that's a big thing for me to say because I wouldn't normally say that. I feel like it's really special because I've put my absolute all into it and there's been a few little things that have gone on this past year that I've been a bit, you know, ups and downs and things. And I think that, you know, this album is just like, I've poured me kind of heart and soul into it, which I hope people, it represents it. There's a lot of emotion in the album.
Are you hinting to me that there were obviously some dark days in the last year?
Well, not really, you know. I mean, the parting ways with Psycho was kind of it was more of a positive thing. I'm a very positive person and I turned it onto a positive spin. I was like, okay, what's next? Let's move on. We were discussing the show with Popstar Overstar. I had lots of other deals on the table. I was like, let's get on with everything. And I wanted to use the kind of knock, I suppose, is what people would call it, as an advantage.
Do you call it that?
Well, I don't really call it that because I kind of was like, right, let's explore everything. And it kind of made me just go out there and grab everything and kind of take the reins of everything and be like, right, what's next? And be the driving force that I needed to be, that I wasn't when I was with Psycho, because I got a bit lazy and I kind of let them take control because I was behind this huge brand and I could let them take control. And I'm so thankful for that because I learned so much from them and I'm forever thankful for the opportunity I was given from Simon and the team at Psycho, and I love them all a bit. So it's nice that I can kind of, you know, use that experience that I had with working with them to my advantage.
You think if this album hits number one, he'll be calling you, texting you, saying, okay, good on you?
Me and Simon are great friends, and I'll forever be thankful to Simon for the opportunity that I was given, and I don't have a bad word to say about him. I admire him so much.
Let me say this, Joe McElderry, there is no way that you were never going to record again with that voice, this talent. And I know you still have the passion and the drive. This is what you've always wanted to do.
It is. I'm in awe of what I'm doing. I absolutely love it. And as long as I get to perform and sing and people enjoy it, that's all I care about. I'm here for the music, that's it.
What are the maybe one or two songs of the album, the tracks that mean the most to you?
I think Dance with My Father, definitely. Canta de la Terra is a special one for me. Time to Say Goodbye, I love that one. And probably Somewhere Over the Rainbow as well.
Special songs, which have been recorded by so many other people. Were you nervous about recording any of those? Because, and especially with the language issue.
No, I just give them a bit of McElderry love. I just try to put my own stamp on them and try and make them my own, you know. And that was important, that it people recognise my voice and that I wasn't trying to be something that I'm not. And I think hopefully that comes across in the record.
And the new series is coming up. Will you tune in?
Definitely. I'm a massive fan. I can't wait. I'm excited to see what the new judges are like. I'm going to miss Cheryl, Simon and Danny, obviously.
It's going to be weird, isn't it?
It is going to be strange, but I think it was time for a shake-up. And I think, you know, as much as I would have loved to have seen Cheryl there, I think, you know, maybe it was time for them all to move on.
And I know that, of course, she's moving on. I know you two are texting all the time.
Yeah.
She's getting ready for the new album.
Yeah. I absolutely love Cheryl a bit. And we're still keeping contact. And whatever she does, it turns to gold. So she's going to be absolutely fine.
For the rest of the year, what are you up to? What do you want to do?
I'm going on tour in November around the UK, which I'm really excited about. And that we're announcing the dates next week. And yeah, I've just heard something very exciting from somebody, a part of my team, that could be an amazing thing happening in January, but we'll see. I can't.
And that is?
It's very different, I think, to what a lot of people will expect, but it's amazing. I am a bit of a teaser, but I can't say anything yet, but hopefully it'll pull off.
Life, I'm thinking, you've just worked so hard to get this album ready, now it's out next week. A life away from the music, all good?
Everything's great, you know. I'm enjoying spending time with my friends and family when I can.
Good to see you again.
They do. And hoping for a holiday soon, but don't tell anybody I said that.
I won't say that. You'll get away soon.
Yeah, but I'm just enjoying being busy and craziness that involves the life of Mr. McElderry, but it's good fun.
Where do you want to be in 5 years' time?
Happy, healthy, and performing. And if everything like that happens, then I'll be very happy.
Album classic out next week. Joe, good luck with it. I don't think you need it. I've heard it. Sounds great.
Thank you. And I hope everybody enjoys it. And I want to just say thank you to everybody for the continued support that I've received, because it's very humbling. And it's just amazing. I can't thank people enough.
Joe, good to see you. Thank you so much.
Pleasure. Thank you.
It was so we should.